Hello everyone, welcome back. It is Marksman here, bringing a game of Search and Destroy on Bakara. This is a very late upload, I apologize. I had some stuff to do throughout the day. I woke up late to begin with, and then I was doing some laundry and chores, you know, yada yada, whatever I can get done on the weekend before I gotta go back to school. I got classes again, I mean, always have, but starting tomorrow, and for a few more weeks, then I'll be done. But I need to get my laundry done. So I had to get that done, and I just can't do a commentary while my laundry's going because the mic is so sensitive. Regardless, I hope you all get the chance to see this. It is a 16-2 gameplay with a striker. Spoiler alert, late spoiler alert, I should say, because I told you already. But Bakara, as a map in general, is a very long, elongated map. It's kind of like Crossfire, to be honest, from Call of Duty 4, I think that was Crossfire. And I mean, obviously it's not the same, but it's very similar. You can't lie. I mean, it's a big elongated map that slopes downward from the top to the bottom and is like a cityscape, you know? And usually people use rifles and snipers on this map, especially in COD 4. But I've actually found that a shotgun works really well on this map if you know how to use it. Excuse me. And this is because A is such like a, it's such a fortress. You can get inside the buildings near A, and you can just dominate close range. And you saw that sniper, how he saw me on the top of that building. He's not going to push me, one, because he's got a sniper, and two, because I have a shotgun. And he knows the range that I can hit him with that, and he doesn't want to get anywhere near me. And since he didn't get near, he couldn't defend the bomb. My guy defused it while I was guarding him, and they lose the round because of it. So I think A is one of the best places to arm the bomb. You'll find people go B a lot if they're using rifles or if they're using snipers, because they're going to sit at the top of the street, head glitching cars, and they're going to snipe down the alley. And that works too, but at the same time, there's an easy counter to that when you rush up middle, like really simple. So I don't do that rush in this game because those guys don't push B that much, but at the same time, I just wanted to let you know, if you have people pushing B, most of the time, they're using snipers. If you have people pushing with submachine guns and shotguns, that's pretty rare, actually. I haven't found people that do that ever, to be honest. But if you do run into that kind of game, you're going to have to push back. You can't let them take over B, because once they're in these buildings, it's really hard to get them out of them. If they're sniping, though, rush up middle. You'll see that little car, little truck I just kind of shot that dude near. If you throw stuns over that truck, you can rush up through middle. If you get hit markers, you got to run left and run around spawn, but otherwise you can run straight up and run around the building and find the snipers that head glitch the back trucks. And that really, I mean, that's where you'll find them. They sit there really, it's a common spot, to be honest, really common. But I hope you guys have been enjoying the search gameplay. I mean, I've been trying to get as many gameplays as I can. I'm glad Infinity Ward gave me back my gameplays, which that was cool. I mean, they reset my account, but they gave me the gameplays, so I'm happy about that, because I did not want to go get those montage clips again. That was hours of sacrifice in, I don't even know what, drop zone, domination, etc. But the search gameplays were mediocre. I mean, you know, I had a few 12-1s, 13-1s, 10-0s that were kind of, only reason I saved them, usually those are pretty low gameplays I won't save, but they had some pretty cool kills that I liked, so that's why I saved them, to be honest. You'll see on offense, I rush right down the street, and I get up to the top of this building, and right now, at this point, we can arm A, and even if it's me versus five people, I'll pretty much kill all of them. I mean, it's hard for them to push me. It just is. This building is a fortress. There's three different entrances / exits, and that's only on the bottom floor. I can jump out the window on the top after I got a kill up here. If they chase me up, I can jump down, and I can jump down without making any sound, too. There's a few places you can jump off of up here to not make any sound when you're hitting the ground, and I think you'll see one of them this game. They might try to do what that guy does, though, and try to hit you from, like, a distance with their sniper. Don't walk near the windows if you can avoid it. Or don't walk near the windows if you can help it. There we go. At that point, I kind of got double-teamed, and it sucked, but, you know, it happens. My teammates were dead. But you see the same rush straight down Middle Street. You have people go on the right tunnels over there. A few members of your team will do that, usually. And if you throw your stuns over this truck, they really can't even get to the right tunnel, so it doesn't make a difference. I usually look middle just because some people go there in game battles to try and stop that rush. And it kind of works, but if you know they're going to be there, you can throw stuns, stun them, and then frag them or semtex them. And it works really well, too, to stop those people. But pistol, yeah, that's not modded. Like, again, though, same rush, same spot. My teammates will arm the bomb. I chill here. Control this building. You control this building. You control A. You control A. You win the round, game, etc. And, yeah, that's pretty much the strategy for Picard, to be honest. There's not much more to it. If you go B, I wouldn't suggest it. I would just say change your strategy up and go A because it's better and easier to control. And that's all about FPS games in general. I mean, control is what matters. You will do it in Halo. You'll do it in Call of Duty. You need control. Map control is best. And it's really easy to see that in Dome. Defense has map control when they spawn. It's not like it's an unfair map. It's a map built on control. And defense easily has a control. So there's a jump to not make any sound when you hit the ground. I'm pretty sure I made that silent. Otherwise, I wanted to just talk about the stream. I've been streaming every day as well. I might not stream tonight just because I have a project due in a few days and then another project due 2 days after that. I have to work on that to get it done because otherwise I'll be spending 10 hours the day before it's due trying to finish it and do it. Or actually start it, do it, and finish it, to be honest. So I might not be streaming tonight. I usually stream every night. I apologize. I passed 100,000 views and 2,000 followers on my stream. That's awesome. Thank you for all who watch the stream and support it. I appreciate it. That dude got turned on horribly. And now I'm back in this building, same spot, camping. But as I said, I hope the stream's fun for you. I'm sorry about Twitch TV chats and stuff like that. We're working our best to get it done as quick as possible. I talked to my team today about it. I might change my chat to our beta chat. It has no moderation skills, to be honest. It's very unmoderated, but it is working fully, so that is a good thing. And that really finishes the game. I would go 16-1, I believe. I don't know. 16-2, 16-1. Thank you for watching, though. If you'd like to, comment, rate, or subscribe. It does help me, and at the same time, I love to read the comments. I love to see ratings, if they're good or bad. Regardless, I like both. I like to know what I'm doing is good and what I'm doing is bad. So, again, thank you. Have a good night, day, wherever you may be, and make sure to keep on gaming.